Today, we're going to talk about an essential tool for onboarding a new employee at your company, the Employee Handbook. Welcome to HR Over Coffee, a series from the experts at HR 360, where you'll learn how to effectively hire, manage, and terminate employees. With all the meetings, introductions, and paperwork involved in employee orientation, it might be tempting to give the Employee Handbook short shrift, but don't do it. The Employee Handbook is one of your first official communications to your new employee, and it should be up to date, detailed, and well written. In fact, your Employee Handbook is the single most important internal document for communicating policies, practices, and employee benefits. It sets forth your expectations for your employees and outlines what they, in turn, can expect from your organization. While the policies outlined in your handbook will reflect your company's own unique culture, these policies also must be drafted in adherence to federal, state, and local laws and regulations. You may even find you need more than one edition of your official handbook. For example, one for exempt employees and another for non-exempt, or for union employees and non-union employees. In any instance, there are a number of key elements to be included in an employee handbook. After a welcome and introduction from your president or CEO, begin with general employment information, provide an overview of your business, and lay out basic policies relating to employment eligibility, job classifications, employee records, job postings, termination and resignation procedures, and, if applicable, union information. Next, address your company's anti-discrimination policies. Depending on the size of the company, employers must comply with a number of different federal and state equal employment opportunity laws prohibiting discrimination. Outline them here and set out a statement of your official compliance. This section is also a good place to set out your sexual harassment and any affirmative action policies. Your handbook should also cover compensation and work schedules. With respect to compensation, include information on federal and state tax deductions as well as voluntary deductions for benefits. Also explain pay schedules, timekeeping policies, and topics such as performance reviews, raises, and bonuses. You should also clearly state your company's regular work hours and schedules and your policy on attendance, punctuality, and reporting absences. If telecommuting or flex hours are an option, cover those here as well. Standards of conduct is one of the most important sections in your handbook. Make sure you document how you expect employees to conduct themselves in the workplace, from dress code to ethics. Remind employees of any legal obligations that they may need to comply with, such as protecting sensitive customer data, and describe your standards related to employee discipline, including any progressive discipline policy. In part two, we'll continue our discussion of the Employee Handbook, beginning with the topic of safety and security. In the meantime, if you have any questions regarding employee handbooks, visit us online at hr360.com and try our Employee Handbook Builder, an interactive tool allowing you to generate a custom handbook for your company simply by answering a few questions. And as always, it's wise to seek the counsel of a reliable employment law attorney when drafting an employee handbook.